You think your dad watches your streams?
No.
Do you think he has ever seen one secretly?
That's a better question.
He could be watching them. You really never know. You're putting yourself out there 24/7.
You think that my dad watches my streams and, like, a single tear runs down his face and he puts his hand up to the screen and lets it slide down?
I think that
exact thing happens?
I think he tries to talk back to you and pretends like he's having a conversation with you.
Because I never call.
All the ones that he wanted to say to you, he's saying you hear.
That is profoundly sad.
I think that's what we're going to do to our children in the future. They're not going to talk to us, but they're going to stream.
They're going to watch us on stream?
Oh, or that too.
I just want a good relationship with my father, so I watch his video game streams where he makes the poo-poo jokes.
He doesn't tell me about his personal life, but, you know, he talks a lot about himself there, so that's how I find out.
All right, let's welcome to the stream, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
And Ship.
Hey, I'm Ship.
This is Ship. You may or may not know him already. He makes the show Starter Squad on the YouTube or Stolen on the Facebook.
Mm.
I've seen it many a time, Stolen on the Facebook.
I think more people have seen it from there.
Stolen on the old Facebook. Yeah,
as long as you watch it.
I'm at that same point, honestly.
As long as people watch it, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, I don't really give that much of a shit, because it's like, they're not going to see it on YouTube.
I don't care, I just want them to see it, that's why I made it.
Yeah, exactly. I'm of the same mind. I'd rather have them see it on, like, a shitty meme page than not see it on YouTube.
Yeah, the point is to get them to laugh, right?
Yeah.
If they laughed. You never hear it, though.
You just know it's there. Like Jesus.
Somewhere out there, someone's laughing at me. Good.
Oh, man. This is why I like you, Ship. We have the real talks. We know about the profound notion of a person laughing.
You know,
anybody
could be watching this right now, you know. Your dad could be watching this right now, and so you better not say anything bad about him, because he could be watching at any time.
Obama could be watching this right now. He has free time. I saw a thing, and it was like Obama on vacation, and they were like, can you believe he's on vacation? It's like, he's not the president anymore! Like, yes, I can believe he's... What do you want him to... Do you want to put him back in there? Dude, is that what you're getting at?
No, he has to keep doing important things to be considered a serious person. If you're on vacation, I'm not going to take you seriously anymore. It's as simple as that.
It doesn't really matter, but it's like the same... With the same kind of, like, and then the same person was like, Obama played more golf. He played... All the presidents played golf, but Obama played the most golf. And it's like, who took track of that? And did they do it for every previous president? Because if they did, that seems like an actual position that exists.
What, the most golfed president?
No, like, the person who logs the president's golf.
That's really not a full-time job.
Well,
you look at when they're playing golf and say, okay, now, one.
Well, I mean, I would assume you would keep track of previous presidents still.
No, that's the thing. They do it themselves. They write it down on a little scorecard.
And then they turn in the scorecard?
Mm-hmm. Then you know.
It's all bureaucracy. That's what I've always thought, that golf needed something to spice it up. And little did I know, the answer I was looking for was bureaucracy.
It's true. Every president has done that, by the way. They have all golfed, and they've all been criticized for golfing. Every single one.
You'd think one would just stop golfing.
It must be really good. Golf must be amazing.
Golf must be great. There's got to be something about it that, like... Once you get rich to a certain extent and you no longer want for anything, and you're just like, yeah, now I understand golf.
I mean, how... Dude,
that's my goal, to be rich enough to understand why golf.
it's such a huge waste of resources. It's a huge tract of land. It's a bunch of money that you could be spending and making money in other things. Why else would you do it unless it was amazing?
Yeah, I don't know.
Have you ever tried golf?
I have, but
it's boring, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's why I said it. I think it's something like jazz, where you like you can't really appreciate it fully unless you understand music. Where it's like golf, you can't really appreciate it fully unless you're rich.
I think like you have to have enough money to be like, you know, cruel about it. Like, I have enough money to do all of this instead of making more money.
Maybe it's like the reason that women like shopping. It's like they go out on a golf course and they just think, if I wanted one of these, I could buy one. Maybe I'll get one.
I guess.
And then other rich people go on that, and then they golf, and then they think the same thing. It's a golf cycle. Golf is cyclical. Like rain.
I want to be in the golf cycle. I'm so out of the golf cycle. It's not even funny.
I like how it's like a force of nature, the golf cycle.
I think I'm like on the bottom of the golf chain or whatever it is. I get at the bottom of the circle.
The people that attempt to understand golf?
Oh.
This.
Is that above or below the guy that goes to get the balls?
Oh. I mean... I assume it would be, I would think, like, one is like a surf, but one is, like, a, yeah, okay, I guess the guy who gets the golf balls would be slightly below, but I wouldn't even consider him part of the system, he's just the pillar that it's built on.
Oh, he's more of, like, the scenery?
Yeah, exactly.
It's like a bush or a sand trap.
Yeah, he's part of the atmosphere.
Okay.
Golf is complex.
No, I mean, I like the driving bit of it. I like... That's fun. Have you ever gone to a driving range?
Yes. Yeah, you know. I understand that. My little broke brain can understand the appeal of that.
Me hit ball hard. Ooh, it go far.
Yeah, exactly.
But the rest of it, like...
Yeah, then it's like you got the added complication and you got this little hole and you gotta get the ball in the little hole... And then
you got
to get the little dinky baby club to hit the ball a short distance.
And you have to have all the clubs. You can't just bring one club and use that the whole time.
Yeah, no. You'd think that would be a strategy, right? Because
there's only one ball. You don't have different balls.
Yeah.
And I feel like I could use one club to, like, putt and do all the little things, but no, they have to have slightly differently shaped ones.
Yeah, you would think, like, okay, when you play guitar for a long time, it gets to a point where you have, like, definite preferences, and then, like, you can play other guitars, but if you're using, like, your guitar, it's almost like a fucking, like, you know that thing back and forth, because that's what you practice on, right?
Yeah.
So... You would think there would be at least, like, one guy, like, one golfer that just uses one club that he's, like, super good with.
Oh my god. You could be that guy.
I could be. You'd think that there would be, like, multiples of that guy. You'd think that, like, that would be, like, a whole, like, school of golf.
That one club maybe, for everything?
Maybe I'm overestimating the complexity of golf. But
I don't know. I don't think that's possible.
You think golf is infinite?
I think there's a lot more to golf than humans care to believe.
You think it's beyond perception?
You people are discovering more and more things about golf every single day, and it's always changing the game. I feel like we'll never understand it in our lifetimes.
What's the current meta of golf?
I think it's three, something like par three or something. I don't know how golf works. I'm sorry, I lied.
That's good. It was funny. That's all that matters.
Okay.
Was it you that, like, made a big deal out of that piece of advice? Somebody,
what?
Like, asked me for advice on, like, how do you be entertaining on a live stream or a podcast?
And you said lie.
Yeah, exactly. That's...
Terrible advice.
It's great advice.
No,
we just had a great... I knew nothing about golf. You knew nothing about golf. I've never been golfing. You think I've been golfing?
Wait a minute. Hold on. That was a lie?
Yes!
You never tried golfing?
I've never been fucking golfing!
I actually have been golfing. I was telling the truth the whole time.
I thought you said you hadn't been golfing.
I know, I have been golfing.
Well, now I'm confused.
Now I'm mad at you. You've been lying to me this whole time?
Whatever is funnier in the conversation, that's what you go with. I feel like...
That's so rude. You've been lying... I can't believe you've been lying
to me. It's fucking stand-up rules, dude!
That's not stand-up rules!
Yes, it is! Oh, you watch a fucking stand-up comedian, he goes out, he's like, I saw a guy fucking die the other day, and you're like, oh, yeah, that guy, that really happened to that person.
Yes, he did! He did see a guy die! That's where he gets the material from. He didn't just make that up.
You've seen a real... You have to see a real death.
Yes, before you can't bullshit your way about seeing you death. Have to, that's a traumatic experience.
You have to see life leave a man's eyes.
Absolutely.
Before you can joke about it. Okay.
Dude, don't joke about death without having experienced it firsthand. That's not cool. What else have you been lying to me about? This is traumatizing.
Oof, okay. Well, this really blew up fast.
Oh, no.
Okay. So we're not live streaming right now. I just don't have friends.
You're so mean. I trusted you.
Sorry.
I was like, oh, great. Lyle wants to stream with me. That's fun. We get to play a video game. Oh.
You've been had.
I've been had.
Oh, man. I have been golfing. That was a lie.
I hate you so much!
There's layers to it! And you're so mad!
That's the problem here. I can't trust anything you say now.
That's smart. You shouldn't trust anything anyone says.
Oh, you were trying to teach me a lesson this whole time.
Exactly. This is like the fucking wax on, wax off shit. I get a waxed car, which is a plus for me, and you get to learn something.
I don't like this. I'd rather learn things from people older than me.
I'm your Mihagi ship.
Okay, God damn it. The other thing I learned is that you have to tell the absolute truth in comedy.
Sometimes that's a route to go. You either works, honestly, whichever is funnier. I don't have a strict always lie rule, but if a lie is funnier than the truth, then definitely for the sake of comedy, I will like just fucking make some shit up. I feel like that's like stand-up rules, though.
What?
Fucking, this is exactly what kind of bothers me about, like, streaming and vlogs and just that climate, right? Is,
yeah?
And I've been trying to figure this out for a while, is how do I do, like, a vlog or that type of video? How do I bring stand-up comedy into that and have people get it without being like, okay, guys, I'm joking. All of this is jokes. None of this is my real thoughts. Because, like, when you get up on a stage, everyone just kind of assumes, you know, you're joking however much truth or not isn't in there. But if you make, like, if you sit down in front of a camera and, hey, guys, okay, so this is my thoughts on this, everyone just thinks it's your real thoughts.
I mean, they you can let them think that.
I suppose. I guess that doesn't make it...
So many people have done that, where it's completely not their real thoughts, and they've been taken seriously, and then, like, I don't give a shit.
I guess that's true.
So, I think the secret is just stop caring about that, and do it.
that's probably a good...
That's a really good advice in pretty much every other thing ever. Just stop caring about... Fuck, we lost.
I feel like I feel like you're lying right now.
I mean, I could have been lying at any point in time, especially about not lying, and that would just fuck it up, wouldn't it?
I like how we've casted a fog on the entire rest of this with this first conversation. It's great.
I mean, was there ever not a fog? I as soon as you said want to stream, that's when my guard went up, you know. That's when I I drew first.
It's true. You can't. I'm out for blood. I'm like an animal.
He thinks he's gonna suck my blood. We'll see who gets sucked.
What a twist! It was I who was getting sucked the whole time. I've been had. The suck cycle has begun.
At the end of it, we're both gonna get had, and a third party will benefit.
Exactly. And that's what it's really about.
Yes.
It's really about you.
I was gonna say yes, a third party elsewhere benefiting from the work of us.
Well, no, I meant when I said you, I didn't mean you.
Oh, you, okay. The royal you.
That's creepy music. Royalty free. Anyone can use it. If you want it, you can have it. It's right
Dude,
there.
How much do you think that Kevin MacLeod guy has made over the years?
Like, what do you mean made? Like, how many things has he been in?
No, I mean money. Like, how successful has he been with that shit? Because he's been in everything. But, like, he did that whole licensing thing for, $3 and you don't have to credit him. I bet people do that.
I didn't even know that was a thing.
Oh, seriously? Did you not, like, read the... Oh, I guess nobody reads the
nobody
thing.
Nobody reads it.
They just
oh, no.
It.
I supported him on Patreon for, like, a couple of years. So, maybe I've made good on it. But I mean, that's the thing about it is you fucking appreciate the guy.
If you use
his shit, so...
I hear shit on TV. Which
do
I
you?
Think is amazing. Yes!
Which one do you hear? Do you hear that?
I don't know which one that is. I always hear that.
That's the annoying vlog girl one that all of them use.
I just hear it so much now. I'll probably recognize it if I heard the real thing.
Yeah,
I'm talking about the news one.
That's Kevin MacLeod?
Yeah.
Really?
That's everywhere.
I didn't know that was Kevin MacLeod.
That's why I heard it originally.
I thought that was, like, one of those, fuck, what's it called? Like, I thought that was literally, like, one of those, like, stock bumper things. Like, that door sound that you hear everywhere. I thought it was in there. No, if that's Kevin MacLeod, then goddamn, yeah, he's been in everything. He's been in every single thing.
What I'm saying is, like, if you're using it for TV, I'm sure I'm sure TV people read, right? Don't disappoint me.
Why do you think they watch so much TV? It's because they can't read. Think if their mind was open to the world of literature, would they even want to be TV?
I guess not.
Read a book?
Do you read?
No, I'm not cultured.
You don't.
Are you fucking kidding me?
I don't know why I know why, but, like, just because you read doesn't mean you're completely cultured.
But people who read think that, so I don't want to shit in their cornflakes.
No, what I'm saying is, like, just like there are shitty media everywhere else, there are shitty books, and, like, reading them can make you think you're smart.
But really, you're getting dumber with every word you read.
Well, really, you're just reading. It's nothing more than that. You're just looking at words and getting information that could or could not be useless.
I mean, if you think about it, with, like, Facebook and Twitter, I would go out on a limb and say that this generation reads more than any other generation previous. Not anything of value, but actual reading, I would say that they definitely probably do.
See, I don't know about that. I mean...
The Facebook?
If it weren't for the pictures...
Kids spend all the time on the Facebook!
Okay, like, how much... And 1 hour of... Compare 1 hour of Facebook, or even 2 hours of Facebook, to 1 hour in a book. Like, which one are you... Which person has more words clocked in?
Okay, I see your point. If you're measuring it by words...
Yeah.
I was measuring it by time. And
yes,
maybe this is the great then. Debate, but...
Especially since you're looking at pictures half the time, and now watching videos.
That's true. I don't know, even pictures, though, they have the words, they have the hashtags, you gotta read the hashtags.
Oh, you read a hashtag, and you
it
read a
It still counts
meme.
As
that
one
counts.
Word.
That's one word, that's three words, it had the three words in the meme, that's okay. Well,
it's
what does
still,
it take you like?
What if you're a single guy, right? And a hot girl on your Facebook wall posts yeah. this long fucking shit heartfelt thing, and you're like, I've got to read that.
I have never done that.
But shit,
serious?
She's hot.
I look
it
at her
gives you a window into her mind, and then you know all her insecurities. Maybe I'm talking too much.
Oh
I shouldn't.
I have never done that.
No, I feel like there's a lot of dudes that do that, though.
I might get, like, a couple sentences in, and then I see whether or not I agree with where she's going with it, and then I continue based on what I think.
I've always been paranoid about that. Like, I see someone and they post this big, long, like, thing about themselves and their struggle, and this is me, this is raw, this is what I really am, and it's like, if even one person, even if they're your friend, even one person on your friends list even remotely wants to manipulate you, you just gave them a fucking roadmap. Like, why would you... You trust every single... that person you met one time at a party and then just added, you trust them with that information?
I mean, depends on what information they're putting out there.
Yeah, I guess.
I mean, you let me think.
I'm talking about, like, the whole, like, oh, I moved here a year ago and I've never really felt quite right. I've always felt like, you know, like that kind
yeah.
of thing. Like.
Well, how are you going to manipulate? Like, oh, maybe you could feel right if you do this. Oh, you know, you really get me. I've never really felt quite right. That kind of thing?
Yeah, yeah. Or just, I don't know. I just think you're exposing your weak points. You
yeah,
should never do
if
that.
If someone is engaging with your weak points, they're really making a friendship and not manipulating you.
Engaging with, yeah. But I don't know, if somebody like wanted any of that, like, I don't know.
You're always exposing yourself to people. Like, even when, like, you're, what's it
yeah,
called?
Yeah, but that's because I don't like pants, Ship! Jesus!
But I mean, God damn it. Even when you're, like, you know, telling you people where you are or taking pictures that say where you're going.
Exactly. I never tell people where I am.
You don't post pictures of yourself online? Oh, yeah, you know what? You don't really. It's true.
And even then, I'm so fucking paranoid that, like, if I go somewhere, like, I will post that picture when I get back.
Wow. Well, are you hiding from somebody?
That's a question, Ship. No.
I feel like you're afraid of somebody coming after you.
No, that's like you hear those fucking stories of, like, Uber drivers that, like, they drive people to the airport, and then when they drive them to the airport, they know, like, oh, their house is empty, so they go and fucking rob them. It's like that kind of shit.
That's a good point, actually.
I'm not that paranoid that I'm like, I wouldn't take an Uber to the airport. I'm not, like, that level yet, but...
I'm gonna start giving my neighbor's address when we get picked up at the airport now.
that's actually a smart
right
way
there.
Around that.
They're right there. But okay, yeah, people are dangerous. What else is new?
Exactly. That's why... I don't know, it's one thing to, like, expose that to somebody that you trust. It's another thing to be like, oh yeah, I have 1,000 Facebook friends, and here's everything raw about me.
I feel like what you're exposing is, the information isn't that valuable. It's more of an emotional, this is how I feel.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe, I don't know.
I feel like when you do that, you're, like, baiting people for drama. Like, you want that.
Oh, maybe.
Response.
Maybe you just want people to think about you and talk about you and break into your house because they know you're in Cancun for 2 weeks.
Oh, my God. You came to my house to rob me?
I feel so spent. You wanted my mother's jewelry that she left me when she died?
Dude, that's I feel rich. I feel like I have enough to steal now, and I feel valuable.
I can't believe you were paying attention when I was showing you around my house and all my nice things.
I mean, I feel like we're getting there.
There might be somebody that's like that.
Yeah, like
that...
so lonely and devoid of human interaction that, like, you know, someone wanting to steal their things and, you know, engage with them in a negative way, it's positive. Because, you know, it's engagement in some way.
Yeah, that's true. I guess there's definitely people that, like, act out for attention, so why not You know what? That yeah, you're right. A lot of those, like, I'm so depressed, I'm this and that and the other posts are for attention.
Uh-huh. Negative attention is attention. So, you know, when you're robbing them, you're doing them a favor.
Yeah, you're giving them an attention. So really, I was in the right the whole time.
Come on.
You're
you know
welcome, you Brett. You're welcome I took your golf clubs. You just needed the one anyway. You were great with it.
You can do it. I believe in you. Be the guy that uses one.
God damn. I've been using one of your tweets as my Tinder bio for the last year and passing it off as my own. Since you've helped me, I figure I should give something back. Thanks for the puss. Has it actually gotten you laid?
Whoa! Like,
what the fuck have I said that's gotten you laid? What the fuck have I said on Twitter that's gotten you laid?
Oh, it had to be something. I want to hear this one.
I'm really curious now.
I feel like there's a few things on your Twitter that can get people laid.
Like what?
I could probably choose one at random and it'll work.
Maybe. I guess girls are... There's a certain type of girl that's like, I'm into guys that are broken. And... I don't think they say it like that.
They're broken. They're dead inside. Ooh, that's hot.
There's girls that are into it, trust me.
I mean, yes, definitely.
I just don't know that I've said anything on fucking Twitter that...
It was probably about video games.
So. Yeah. Girls love when you play video games. It was probably like, man, I'm not really liking the story of Final Fantasy VIII so far. And they were like, oh, God, I'm getting so frothy. He said, it was the tweet, girls, you wanted a gentleman? I'll be the gentlest man. So gentle, I won't even touch you. In fact, I won't even acknowledge you exist. Don't call. I forgot I even said that. But that sounds like something
yep.
I would say.
Yes,
and he said, works like a goddamn charm. That's actually, all right, I can see that one kind of working.
Totally.
The best part about reading something that you wrote that you forget that you wrote is it's exactly your sense of humor.
Yep, and you're like, oh, goddamn, I'm hilarious.
Exactly. And then you can just be the worst kind of person.
You think when you're like an old man, you're gonna read through your own tweets all day for entertainment?
Yeah, you know, I've actually done it a few times where I've just scrolled like way back.
Yeah.
I used to do a thing where I favorited tweets that I wanted to, like, remember, and occasionally I stopped doing that because I forgot that I was doing it, but now I just remembered that I was doing it. I should maybe do that again, or maybe not. I don't know.
I was talking more like, you know, you compile them into a book or something,
and
like,
I get,
like a decrepit old man.
I get,
like,
when I get the good old Heimers, I just shoot back through them.
You'll just laugh
and
all
laugh
day.
At my little quips.
Your little book that you don't know where it came from, and you don't know who wrote it, but it's fucking hilarious. Because it's exactly your sense of humor.
Yeah, that would be interesting. Like if you retired, let's say you were like a director or a writer. Well, maybe not a writer if it's Alzheimer's. Let's say you were like a director or you did like short stories or you did fucking like videos or music. Music would probably be the best one.
Ooh,
if you did music. And you had this huge, like, library of music, and you made every song you ever wanted to make, which is impossible, but let's just say you did it. And then you got Alzheimer's. How fucking great would listening to your own music be? Because it would be, like, exactly all your sensibilities, right?
It would depend completely on the level of Alzheimer's. Because you could potentially be listening to the same song every day.
Right, let's say you remember it for, like, an hour.
Oh, that would be great. No, I don't want to say that would be great. I'm going to jinx that. But yes, that would be amazing.
That would be the only circumstance where I'd be like, yeah, I could go for some Alzheimer's.
Well, you better like start creating now and make all your best stuff because Alzheimer's you is going to enjoy it.
Alzheimer's will get me. And then once maybe I should just put, by the way, you have Alzheimer's at the end of every piece of music that I make.
And what? Then, no, I don't.
And then I can, every time I can say, well, Alzheimer's that Enzheimer's. and then I'll die of Alzheimer's. Does Alzheimer's kill you, or does it just make you dumb? Okay.
Oh my god!
Do you forget how to breathe eventually? Is that...
No.
Okay.
I think you just don't understand that you're breathing, or, you know...
Right.
Depends on the level it gets to.
What level Alzheimer's?
I mean, what, level 3 is, like, getting your daughter's face?
Once you get to Alzheimer's 3, then you need 6 people with Alzheimer's, and then you can be Alzheimer's God, where you have red hair, and then you master it. You become Alzheimer's God Super Alzheimer's. Because Toriyama doesn't know how to write, because he has Alzheimer's. So did you see the iDubbbz thing that happened with that weird bitch who vlogs? Yeah, I saw that. I don't know. I think that was one of his weaker ones, honestly.
Which one?
The Tanamongu or whatever. I think it just got a lot of attention because there was a publicity stunt involved, which, to be fair, it was a pretty ballsy publicity stunt, but I don't know, like, I feel like I had no idea who she was, so it wasn't nearly as satisfying seeing her kind of get, like, put on blast.
That seems like the case, like, for most iDubbbz things for me, is he puts people on blast that I don't know of, and then I'm like, who's this person? And, oh, okay. That's funny.
Yeah, I mean, like, Leafy was like, I never fucking liked his stuff ever, and I was like, fucking, who the hell is this guy who, like, just repeats himself and fucking, so I was like, fucking, why are people watching this dude just inarticulately try to get across the same point over and over and over again? So seeing iDubbbz, like, put him on blast and then seeing all the sheep go, oh yeah, I don't like that guy, was just a little bit satisfying. So, I mean, that one was pretty satisfying for me. Okay. I mean, the Keemstar one, I guess, was, you know, whatever. I think that a lot of people don't appreciate that Keemstar being a shit show himself is part of the shit show. Like, if you're indulging in YouTube drama, it's like eating junk food. You don't do it for health reasons, you know?
That's why he eats popcorn.
Yeah, exactly. It's fucking, so, like, seeing the dude also throwing shit who's, like, presenting it, it adds to it, I think, personally. But, I don't know. It's weird. I didn't really, the Tana Mojo or whatever one, I didn't think it was anything, like, because, again, I had no idea who she was. She's, you know, it was just whatever. Was, like, the whole point was, like, what, she makes exaggerating vlogs, and she said the N-word sometimes.
I mean, eventually he's gonna run out of people to put on blast, and that's sort of his thing.
Oh,
now,
I don't think he's gonna run out of people.
Oh, okay. Well,
I think that there's millions.
Well, yeah, there's millions, but how
there's
many?
There's even
millions?
Billions. It could be you next, Chip.
There cannot.
It could
be
you.
There are
he's
not
gonna get you.
He is not.
He's
gonna, get
gonna
me.
Come for you like the tickle monster and get you.
And the tickle monster has never gotten me thus far.
You're
came
fat.
Close in like 2014, but
you're
he's never
faster
gotten
than
me.
The tickle monster.
The tickle monster. I've outsped the tickle monster to this date, and he will never get me.
Ah, man.
And I can sleep at night knowing that the tickle monster is not coming in my room. So there.
The only person coming in your room is you. Because you're lonely.
So be it. I would rather be alone than alone with the tickle monster.
That's a very
and
good point.
And you can write that on my gravestone.
Okay. I'll make sure that you... Oh man, I have to make sure that you die before me? You better hurry
be
the fuck up.
No, that's gonna be hard. You are gonna die before me.
You're right. I know.
I
that
have a feeling.
Yeah, I have a feeling too. I would put money on it if I could win that bet.
You should bet against yourself for something. Can you bet on yourself dying and then kill yourself?
Yeah, but I mean, I don't know what good the money would do you. I guess if you had like a family. You could bet on yourself and then die, and then the money would go to your family.
Who would take that bet?
I don't know. I feel like there's been people that have done that with life insurance, maybe.
No, if you kill yourself, your life insurance isn't good anymore.
Well, that's why you make it look like an accident.
Oh.
You make it look like you died on the job. That's the best place to die for life insurance. Hot tip!
Well, which job do I pick to die on?
Yeah, I don't know. Work in a steel mill. I don't know. Trump wants to bring back coal. That's a good place to die. In a coal mine?
I could die in a coal mine.
Yeah. It's like ideal dying conditions. It's like, it's dark. No one can really... You could like get dead in a coal mine and have nobody find your body.
You can shoot yourself in a coal mine and people will blame the coal mine.
Exactly. There's so many ways.
It's a dangerous place to be.
It is. Why did we do that?
Are we gonna lose again?
Probably. We didn't have a tank for the whole, like, first 90% of this, and then I realized that we didn't have a tank, and I was like, I should stop being McCree. Oh. And then I stopped being McCree, but I think it's too late now. Yeah. I feel like the aftershock of me being McCree has already ruined everything.
Yeah, that's most games.
Yeah, good old video games. I actually don't like this map. I feel like that first point, like, you have to go under that bridge. It's one of the only maps that has a choke point that is just completely unavoidable.
You can go to the left of the bridge.
No, you can't. Well, you can do it if you're, like, Pharah. There's certain characters that can, like, go over the whole thing.
Right.
But you can't not filter into that bridge as certain characters.
Oh, no, you can go to the right of the bridge.
Yeah, but you have to go under
the second little bridge.
Yeah, but you have to go under the bridge to go under the second little bridge.
Oh.
That's not on the other side of it. It's...
Okay. Yeah.
Have to filter into that one point.
One choke point's dumb. But wait, doesn't Hanamura have one choke point?
Where? The room?
The door.
No, you can go around the right and come up on that top area. Or you can go around
right.
on the left.
Can.
If you can make that jump, you can go around the left.
No, that's the jump is what I'm talking about. Okay, well, now we just have to hold the choke point.
Yeah, okay. Video games.
Okay.
I'm playing as character that everyone loves.
People ask you what you do, do you just say video games?
It's just me, Bastard. No, I live a weird existence, dude, where I fucking play video games to afford working.
That's stupid.
Yeah, it's backwards as fuck.
Not what you're doing is stupid, but just like how it works is stupid.
Yeah, remember content? Remember when the internet was good?
Oh, no. I don't think it was ever good. I feel like we all have nostalgia about it, but I don't think it was ever good.
I think it was good at a point. I think it was good when the phrase, who cares, it's just the internet, was a thing.
Oh my god! I thought it was amazing that that used to be such a thing. That it was like, people are getting angry at me on the internet. Oh, but like, it's not real, you know? It's not...
Now it's almost had the opposite effect.
Now it's like, they wrote it on my wall, that's harassment.
Yeah, now it's a... I have a friend that pointed this out, and he put it really, really well. He said it's like, now it's the complete opposite, where people treat the internet like it's their house. Where if you put something on the internet, they're like, how dare you say this in my house? But then they also write things that you would only say in your house, you know? Like, they write shit that you wouldn't say in public, and then they're like, how could these people be like this? So it's just this fucking... huge shit show.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, no, it's like, when he said that, I was like, oh my god, that is a very true observation.
My house.
But yeah, no, people, it's weird where people are, like, more hypersensitive on the internet than they are, like, walking around just being guys.
Oh, that's true, because when you're walking around, you put, like, this sort of front of politeness now. You don't really explain your feelings the way you do on the internet because you don't have the same amount of anonymity.
Yeah, right. You can't just fucking, like, step out into the light and be like, oh, I have some opinions! Or you can, but it's seen as, like, a mental breakdown and not just a thing you do 3 times a week.
Ah, what a shame.
There's gotta be people that just... I mean, technically, technically I'm a professional complainer, but I do it for giggles and not...
Do you?
Yes. I do it to make the world laugh.
And not like...
And not to make a difference. I don't do it to make a difference.
So are you really a confessional professional complainer if you never make legit complaints? And you're just making sort of jokey complaints?
I was just saying that to cover my ass in case someone in the chat was like, you're a fucking hypocrite. I think it's different, but I'll admit that there's similarities.
If anything, you're the least professional complainer of all.
Yeah, but I think the keyword you're zeroing in on is professional.
Yes, which I'm saying, profession.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder what this would look like on a resume if I ever wrote it out.
What, professional complainer?
No, just everything that I do. Just
your life?
Yeah.
Do you have a resume?
I mean, I do and I don't. I've never applied for, since I've been doing this, I've never applied for something that isn't entertainment, so... Mm-hmm. I wonder what this would look like on a resume if I was trying to get, like, a position at, like, a law firm or something.
What?
Like, if I was like, oh yeah, I want to be, like, a secretary for a law firm, and I want to wear the high heels and the mini skirts.
Okay, so you'd have to tailor your resume so to if I, or
even,
work.
Even, I'm trying to think, like, what would be, like...
No, that means you have to spin all the things you've done to sound like they are secretarial, or they include the duties that a secretary would do.
Okay.
So you take the aspects of things you've done, and, like, you know, if you play video games, I guess, you're like, I use the keyboard. I use this keyboard 12 times, that's a bad example. But you know what I mean.
I'm trying to think of something that would have, like, no crossover, but still, like, isn't like a service job or something that doesn't like something that requires professional experience, but that I couldn't be like, I use the computer. Although I guess using the computer is what people over 40 think that work is now. So
oh, absolutely.
It's
yes and no, it depends.
It's like witchcraft to them.
I'm a social media expert.
Yeah, that one I could probably.
You can
say what you will. Like I put out some fucking fire tweets. A man told me earlier today that one of my tweets gets him laid. Do you understand what this feels like? Do you understand what power on this level is, Ship?
I guess I don't. I will say that a lot of people will look at your numbers and not your content. So you could easily be like, I managed a Facebook page with 20,000 likes, or I managed a Twitter account with however many Twitter followers you have.
Yeah, I think I'm over 50,000 now.
That matters way more than, like, well, on a resume anyway, and for getting your foot in the door to people.
But then I say, it makes almost exclusively masturbation jokes.
No, just leave that part out. They won't even check it. They'll just look at the number.
I feel like it's kind of hard to miss, though.
I mean, you'd be surprised.
Is my pinned tweet about jacking off right now? I don't know. What is my pinned tweet? What? How do? And follow up, why? Could we?
Could we what?
Exactly.
Is that all it says?
Mm-hmm.
How do and follow up, why could we?
These are...
That can't be your pinned tweet.
No, it's not my pinned tweet. It's the question that we all should be asking ourselves to really know who we are. You know why JFK got assassinated, Ship? It's because he didn't think to ask these questions. It's like looking both ways before you cross the street. You've got to ask a cryptic word salad, and then you don't get shot from the grassy knoll. When I'm running things, I'm going to be ready.
I'm sorry, what answer could JFK have given to that that would have saved him?
He should have said, don't shoot me.
Ah, that would have made him think.
Yeah, if I was going to assassinate a president, and I'm not... But if I was gonna, and he was like, don't shoot me, I'd be like, ah, man, okay, you got me.
Other people have told me not to shoot him, but he has never told me that.
Yeah.
I'm tired of people speaking for the president. I want him to speak for himself. And if he tells me not to shoot him, I'm not gonna.
Yeah, exactly. The president himself has never... How do I know he doesn't want me to shoot him?
He probably does.
So we're on a list now.
That's a stressful job. He probably wants to die. Come on.
Does
Have
the
you
president
ever worked
get,
in an office?
Like, does the president get, like, a fancy gun for his desk? Like Hitler? Not like, you know what I mean, though.
Does Hitler the president get Hitler's gun? Probably.
I'm sure if he really wanted it, the president could procure Hitler's gun. But does the president get, like, a fancy... Does he get, like, a fancy gun like Hitler had? That's, like, a presidential gun? I know he gets a pen. He gets a pen, doesn't he? There's, like, a big thing when the president gets a pen. It's like George Washington's pen. There's some kind of special pen that the president gets.
Do you think he gets a gun?
Yeah. In case being the president, you know, is hard.
I wouldn't give the president a gun. I wouldn't give anyone in a high-stress situation like that a gun. I feel like he would think about it, you know?
What about a baby and it's to defend itself?
I would not give a baby a gun.
Wow.
It would kill itself.
Typical liberal.
It would!
What, you just want a baby to be defenseless when the terrorists come to get it?
I don't think the baby is smart enough to not succumb to its own urges and kill itself.
You take the Second Amendment away from the baby, and you take the First away, and then the baby will never talk.
I feel like I'd rather have that.
I feel like a lot of people shouldn't talk, shouldn't be able to talk.
I feel like there
should
be a law.
Yeah, I think you should be able to... You should have to get a certain amount of good at math. And then you can talk. Then you're allowed to speak.
Really? I would have gone with English, but, I mean, fair's fair.
No, I mean, who gives a shit if they can... That's what we have right now!
What?
And it's not working!
Well, you need an English requirement to be able to talk?
Yes, you need to understand English to talk!
Okay, that's true.
The key word here is certain level. Like, if you know the quadratic... I wouldn't qualify. I can't
this?
Even talk right now.
Every week...
If you know the quadratic equation, then you get to talk. If you don't, sorry.
Well,
Einstein didn't talk till he was, like, six.
That's not true.
Don't let anyone tell you can't make the next A-bomb.
Just shut up. I think that every week we should be given a riddle, and if we can solve the riddle, we get to talk for that week, and if we can't, we have to shut up for one whole week.
The Sphinx comes to your house and fucking gives you a riddle?
It's probably like a giant mouth or something. It would be like a metaphor that no one would be able to understand. But if you can solve the metaphor, or the riddle for, then you can talk forever.
Well, like fucking, oh... Oh.
If you could figure out why the Sphinx is shaped like that, then you have permission to always talk.
But
otherwise,
what would stop a talker from telling you?
He Why would he has an advantage. Why would he want that? Why would he want to give that to somebody else?
Yeah, but it's like, what if that person's like his buddy or something? What if they've been like signing to each other to conspire?
If he's smart enough.
Yeah, you know
what?
I think you have to be. If you are smart enough to understand sign language, you'd probably figure out the riddle.
Yeah. But that's the cruel twist is that once you can talk forever, no one can understand you.
Oh, fuck! Oh, shit! No! Oh, that's good! Oh, fuck! Dude! Ah, this is some Black Mirror shit. That was really good. That was really good. Oh, no, man. Seriously, if I'm ever fucking forming a society, you're gonna be, like, the first person I call. I need to incorporate as many...
control them.
Not even, we just have to have, like, a cruel gauntlet of riddles and twists.
I have always vouched for a cruel gauntlet in society, and everyone's always looked at me weird. I feel like... Well, not that we need, like, the gladiatorial arenas back.
I would want that, too, but that for a different reason.
We need something similar. We need a cruel gauntlet that's not, you know...
Yeah, I feel like we need, one, we do need physical blood sport, and we also need, like, the mental equivalent of blood sport.
Yes, that's what it is.
I feel like that one is easier to sell with the right packaging, whereas if you're just like, I want to watch people die, that's a little tougher.
UFC is pretty close.
It is.
Gladiatorial fights.
It
and
is.
I'm okay with that. I watch UFC.
Yeah.
It's entertaining. It's the blood sport that I'm looking for.
Right.
Without the death.
But yeah, you're right. But I feel like that would ratchet it up just a little bit. But yeah, the mental equivalent of blood sport, I feel like you could sell that. But
absolutely.
you just can't use that exact phrasing that I just used.
Mental blood sport.
Yeah, you want to stay away from that.
You
also maybe don't want to use the term cruel gauntlet. So we've got to stay away from that one too.
I don't know if you make it like a TV show, maybe.
Yeah.
People would buy that mentality. And,
yeah,
you know,
I guess you can get away with a lot if you film it.
Absolutely. Yeah, people would sign up to die if there weren't like FCC regulations.
You know what? I think that they should do a thing where if you qualify for assisted suicide, you can enroll in blood sport.
This is what.
I mean, okay. So granted, you wouldn't be seeing like gladiators. You'd be seeing like leukemia patients and like people. Yeah, people.
I don't know if I'd want. I don't know if
you
I'd
wouldn't
want
to see like a leukemia patient like punch a vegetable to death.
Oh, no, that's physical. I thought you meant the leukemia patient would be doing the mental blood sport.
Oh, no, no, why does that matter?
Because he'd be, like, coughing and trying to figure out the riddle, and he'd just be, like, in pain.
No, I was saying for regular blood sport.
Okay.
Sorry, you got me all wrapped up in that now.
You're right. I could go for that. I mean, that's where we start, then.
Yeah.
If we're trying to change the legality of it, we need to go through the people that are already dying.
Yeah, already qualified to die.
What would they have to gain from it, then?
I don't know. You go out in a blaze of glory?
Here's even more chemo.
I mean,
they can't afford it! They can't afford it!
They can't afford it! No, oh my god! Holy shit, only in America! I've finally found the one advantage of privatized healthcare, and it's this. And they're not even doing it! Alright. I'm with it. I'm on the Ted Cruz bandwagon.
We could do it. We're in the position. We're in the right country.
Yeah. I mean, in for a penny, in for a fucking pound, as they say in the UK, where they have good healthcare.
This is undoubtedly one of those things that you talk about it, and, like, it sounds entertaining, and then when you actually do it, like, you understand the horror of it.
Right, but I don't see why that would make it any less good. I feel like, in practice, the horror is the best element.
Okay, that's true.
So we're only ratcheting up the meat and potatoes of this idea, really.
Mm.
The more horrible it gets, the more true to form it is.
Okay, In that case...
See, maybe this is why I don't trust people knowing where I am or knowing how I feel.
Because
I have thoughts like this, and I know that there's people out there that fucking think like this.
I was gonna say that if you really want to ratchet that bit up, after they win at the end, where you're like, all right, you finally won, here's all the money for your chemo, after the cameras turn off, you just take it away. You just don't give it to them, so that you don't have to spend it.
Yeah, I mean, okay, let's be real here. We've had a cure for cancer for a while, they just don't want to release it, so maybe this is the only way to get it.
Oh.
Maybe enough people have to die, so they go, okay, we give you a fighting chance. But you have to, you know, you have to kill your competition.
Huh.
I mean, that's more humane than, like, a waiting list. It makes it a meritocracy. So. And, of course, to make it fair, we'd have divisions, right? Like, we'd have a cancer division, and a leukemia division, and a progeria division. We don't tell them that there's never going to be a cure for that. But I still want to see those fight.
It wouldn't be super fair. I mean,
wouldn't
like
it be weird? Wouldn't it be weird if there was like one disease or something that, like, through this we found out made you more powerful?
Oh no!
Wouldn't it be strange?
Bad side of these people.
Like, okay, there was that dude that like ran in the Olympics, right? And he had no legs.
Yeah.
The Blade Runner, the guy who like had no legs, and then he like shot a woman.
Yeah.
Right. So he, like, won the regular Olympics. He, like, won the regular thing. But they figured out that having no legs and those prosthetics actually, in a certain fucked up way, gave him a sort of advantage because he knew how to run on them. And it required, like, less something or other.
Well, yeah, you don't have your legs don't get tired. One, you have less weight. I assume there are a few other things, but I would automatically assume having no
right,
legs,
right.
Having...
So like, what if you found out that like Huntington's disease gave you like super strength or something, like, or just made you really resistant to pain, like it made you like a giant callus, you know, or just something like that.
I feel like...
What if we figured it out, and then we'd be, like, recruiting these people for warfare? We'd have an Alzheimer's platoon all listening to their own music and fucking... they don't even remember. We instill in it that they are monsters, and then they don't even remember what humanity is, so they feel no remorse. And even if they do feel remorse, they don't remember it. Oh, my God.
Alzheimer's would be a shitty army to have.
Yeah, I guess they'd forget what side they were on, wouldn't they?
I think they'd just forget that they were in an army.
No, I feel like you could actually play with that and do like if you could medically induce Alzheimer's to where it kicked in like the prime of your life, you could probably do some like Manchurian Candidate like Winter Soldier shit with it.
So brainwashing.
No, not... Well, I guess, yeah, it'd be, like, a more indirect brainwashing.
Yeah, you're just running hoops around, like, the thing you want to do. I feel like the soldier system that we have now is good enough.
I mean, I feel like we do a good enough job.
Yeah, they already kind of brainwashed them in the boot camps and all that. I mean, that whole thing is about breaking you down and making you, you know, a mentally different person.
That's true.
Well, you want to pitch them your Alzheimer's idea?
Yeah!
Let's give everybody Alzheimer's in this
Look,
army.
Look, if there's
better.
A patent behind it and I can make some money, fine. Yeah, let's pitch the Alzheimer's idea.
I don't know if Alzheimer's is the way to go. That seems like... Oh, you get a loot box.
That's why nobody thinks Alzheimer's is the way to go. That's why no one's thought of it yet. But there's only one way to find out. We should get a grant behind this. I feel like this is the time if you want to get a horrific grant for... Something that would usually be considered a war crime. Now is the time.
Isn't Alzheimer's just brain deterioration? I mean, why are you going this far? Why don't you just, you know, hack into their minds? Not like, you know, hack, but like, literally lobotomize people.
I feel like there's a lot you could cut out that would probably not make a good soldier.
Moreover, who would sign up for the... Oh, soldiers. Yeah, okay. All right. I get it. I don't like it, but I get it.
And that's the moral here today.
I get it.
I get it, but I don't like it. I was on some painkillers recently, and I was just saying shit while I could get away with it. Like, I wasn't even that high. I was just like, you know what, I had a weird thought, but I have an excuse to vocalize it now. I would normally vocalize it, but, you know, it would be weirder. Now I have, like, full pass to say whatever the hell I want.
Damn, well, you kind of always do, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't, like, bad shit, it was just weird shit. Like...
I mean, you kind of always do, don't you?
Yeah, I guess.
I mean, I feel like I never hear you censor yourself, especially when you should.
That's kind of true. No, I think that there's like a weird middle ground with self-censorship where if it sounds too real, then you've got to censor it. But if it's like so horrible that like it shouldn't be a human thought, then you're like, okay, I got to get this out there.
I guess, but where's your line? I mean, there's a lot that could sound.
I guess my line is when it sounds like a cry for help. That's my line. There's like a middle ground where it's like. You can say shit that's like, oh yeah, I'm gonna fucking blow my brains out while jacking off and jumping into helicopter blades. You can say that, but you can't be like, man, I'm not having a good day. I should kill myself. You know?
Yeah. I'm gonna kill myself while not jacking off and being as far away from a helicopter as possible.
Exactly.
Oh, no, are you okay?
Yeah, yeah. You're like, you're not talking about helicopter blades or large vehicles with lots of gears and cogs to get ground up in. What's wrong? Look, as long as my corpse isn't intact when I die, then it's something I can vocalize.
I've been thinking about donating my body to science a lot recently. I'm a little bit worried about what they're gonna do, but I'll be dead, but like, I feel like people that I know in life might run the chance of somehow running into my body if it's out there in circulation.
See, I figure, this is how I see it, right? I don't think anything happens afterwards. So the way I see it is, if you donate your body to science, that's the only way that you might come back to life.
Oh no! I don't want to!
I'm just saying.
Oh no.
It's the only way to do it!
Donate your body to science! No, I want to stay dead. There's a chance they might bring me back, and they better not.
There's a chance in hell that someone might Frankenstein you back into existence.
I don't have consent, I'm dead. They can just bring me back to life. I'd be under their control.
I mean, you're assuming they'd figure out how to reprogram you before they'd bring you back.
Maybe.
I mean, Frankenstein went rogue, didn't he? He escaped and shit. So... I mean, I guess Frankenstein's the doctor, but everyone just calls the fucking monster Frankenstein. Well,
yeah, but Frankenstein's monster, he wasn't one guy. He had, like, his own personality.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Wasn't he made up of, like, a bunch of different brains?
I don't know if he had a bunch of different brains. I know he had a bunch of different parts. I don't know
parts of a brain or something.
Yeah, I'm not entirely sure. He wasn't too fucking articulate, I'll tell you that.
Oh, no, I was gonna say the only thing I know is that he was really articulate.
Oh, yeah, that he... really verbose, Frankenstein's monster.
Yes.
He was like, I do say, Master, I'm privy to some of this information, and I don't approve.
I know you're joking, but yes, that's what Frankenstein was like. Like, he chased Dr. Frankenstein to the ends of the Earth because he wanted revenge.
Wait,
it's
what?
Weird.
Seriously?
Like, in the movies, he's like, he's this big, lunky guy. But, like, he talks and shit, and he's a guy.
Wait, so this is like the original novel.
Mary Shelley's Frankenstein.
So in the original novel, is he super articulate? Is that actually... Really?
Yes.
Interesting.
He's a guy.
That's like Dracula, though. Dracula is much different in the fucking novel. There's much less bleh. And there's a lot of really weird powers that he has that they don't quite mention.
Why do we turn these, like, really complex monsters into, like, bleh, bleh, boo?
I think because that's, like, what the human brain has the capacity to fucking think of as evil. Once you start making it more complex and give it, you know, motivations and stuff, then you start sympathizing with it. And I feel like the era, especially, that a lot of those come from, or at least the movie adaptations, is important. Because it's like... At that point in time, film is like, it's all gotta be shorthand, it's all gotta be, like, super, like, bad guys and good guys, and this is scary, this is evil, so it's gotta have no nuance to it.
That makes me so sad for, like, the future of media, and how we're just gonna take everything that we liked about what we like today, and just dumb it down to its bare roots.
Well, I feel like now it's going a little bit the opposite route, where everything's like a deconstruction, like, is Batman really good? Is, you know, like, we're seeing it in places where it almost doesn't belong.
And the places where it does belong, we're later gonna be like, you know, Breaking Bad is just gonna be me bad, super bad.
Me bad, and now I have to break! Me, Walter White, break, because Walter White, bad.
Meanwhile, Hello Kitty is going to be like, you know, a deep manifestation of what it means to not have a mouth and not be able to speak.
So what exactly is Hello Kitty? Is she just a mascot that they put on fucking pencil cases and shit? Or, like, is there, like, a character behind that? Is she like a Mickey Mouse in Japan?
What's the difference?
Well, I guess that's true at this point. But Mickey Mouse was a cartoon character at a point.
Yeah, so it's Hello Kitty.
There's movies about him. So there's movies about Hello Kitty.
Yeah, there's Hello Kitty series.
Okay, I've never seen or heard anything about Hello Kitty in media. I've just seen her slapped on products.
Well, a Japanese person would probably say the same thing about Mickey Mouse.
That's a good point. I'm not saying that's wrong. I'm just saying I didn't know. I didn't know.
Yeah, there you go.
I know I'm the kind of person that you would expect to know quite a bit about Hello Kitty, about the Hello Kitty mythos.
Frankly, I'm surprised. The lore is really deep.
Yeah.
I really liked the Froggo arc in the last season of Hello Kitty.
I don't even know if that's a real thing or not. I don't know how angry I should be at that comment you just made. Oh, shit. You just got fucking saved by that floor pig.
Yep.
From the pig, by the pig. Oh, jeez. Okay.
Live by the pig, die by the pig.
From pig we began, and to pig we will return.
It's kind of fucked up. I feel like... this has been explored probably a lot, but by making animals delicious and eating them, we are continuing their existence. Animals that aren't as delicious, we don't farm.
Oh, exactly. Like cows? There's no way that thing would be fucking kicking around if we weren't...
keeping its survival.
You think it's got survival in it? I'm sure that undomesticated cows would be a lot different.
Wild cows?
Yeah, I mean, there's buffalin.
Oh, yeah, there is buffalin.
Those look like they can fucking, survive on a plane. You know, cows, I don't know. I guess all they really do is eat grass and shit, so there's not a lot to them. What about water, though? How do cows get water if you don't give them a water trough?
They go to a river.
Yeah, but those are becoming extinct.
I mean, we have deers that survive, but the thing is, deers are fast.
Yeah, that's true. Cows aren't fast.
Cows would develop a predator that would just eat them meat. Well, they have, actually, but ironically, us being the predator has made them...
yeah, more powerful.
More powerful?
Well, maybe that's not the right terminology, but you know what I mean.
I know what you mean, yeah. Powerful. That's why I think that if we really want to save, polar bears and shit, we should start farming and eating them.
That's a good plan.
Why are we trying to conserve them anyway? Why are we trying to control them?
Yeah, what
that?
Do they do for us? Fucking polar bears. Some things... You ever wonder if, by making efforts to conserve certain things, we're, undoing nature?
Yes,
we are. Because that's, how evolution works, right? Is the animals that are shitty at survival don't survive. That's why we don't have dinosaurs anymore, because they sucked. Yeah, I said it. They ate too much.
I just read something in the comments that made me want to be oh yeah, never mind, I forgot about that. Cows are fast. They are very fast.
Are they really?
Yes.
Bulls are fast.
I keep forgetting about that.
Is that sexist to say? The bulls are fast, but cows are not fast?
Because we always see them, milling around in fields of grass and shit. But if you've seen, a cow run, they are very fast. It could outrun you easily.
So are you saying that if there was a stampede of cows... and they were all screaming your mother's name and chasing you.
Mm-hmm.
You would have to confront that eventually?
I mean...
You couldn't run forever?
I mean, it would be a very short confrontation.
But Ship, they know your mother's name.
Well, obviously, that's why I'm running. Otherwise, it'd be they're just cows.
Okay. What would you say to a cow that was screaming your mother's name?
I'd probably say, ah! Wah! And I'd die immediately. I would be thinking all these complex thoughts about how this cow knows my mother's name, but I wouldn't be able to articulate them.
Just scream at it?
Ah! Someone trained these cows. One of my enemies trained these cows and sent them after me. I don't have time to articulate that thought.
I mean, they're not out to kill you, but they're chasing you, and they have information.
What has ever chased me that is not out to kill me?
What if they're a metaphor, but made real? They're a metaphor for your repressed thoughts and your regrets, and that's why they're screaming your mother's name.
I assumed that that's what they were from the beginning. That's part of why they're scary.
Exactly.
I wouldn't be able to outrun them. No, even in this metaphor.
Yeah, but why would you die?
What do you mean?
What about that kills you?
They're cows!
Do you think they're gonna chase you into a fucking coal mine or something? I think that you could live. I think that you could...
If a cow knocks you over and steps on you, you'll die.
I'm not saying they're trampling you, I'm just saying they're chasing you. They want to catch up to you.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. There's a stampede of cows chasing after me, and they don't intend to step on me.
No.
I would never have this thought. I would immediately...
intend to encircle you, and then walk around you slowly, screaming your mother's name and making
That's
full eye
worse.
Contact.
That's
I know, right?
Worse.
It's terrible!
That's an infinitely worse. What are we on, Kings Row?
Yeah, I think we're defending now.
Okay. God damn. Okay, I guess then I'd have to face the confrontation because they just encircle me. Bunch of cows screaming my mother's name and encircling me. I don't know. I'd be like, what do you want? Why?
What if they just and they just keep screaming it? What do you think the thing that you would scream that would be the final mental break to get them all to disperse? What do you think that would be?
It's my father's name?
that'd be your equivalent to, it's all my fault!
I mean, what else? They clearly want me to say something. They're not, you know, they're not attacking and they want a response. I mean, that's the only logical one. That's the opposite of my mom is my dad. Right?
I don't know how exactly that works. I mean, if we're going total opposites.
Uh-huh. What, your un-mom?
Like, I mean, well, just by nature of being another human being, your dad is not your opposite of your mom. If we're going on, like, a physical level, like...
Okay, then what's the opposite of your mom?
I don't know. What fucking molecular structure makes up your mom?
Well, you know, just because they're both human doesn't make them opposites. I mean, opposites are both from the same category. That's what makes them opposites and not just random different things.
I guess that's true. There's gotta be, like, a... You're right. Yeah, they've gotta be along the side, like, the same plane...
Mm-hmm. That's why your dad is the opposite of your mom. That's what I'm going to tell my children, and I'm going to have them repeat that, and I'm going to hit them.
So their mom will opposite hit them.
Yes.
Their mom will unhit them.
Well, what's the opposite of hitting? Petting?
No, because they're both striking actions. I guess it would be like you would have to... Yeah, I guess it would be close to a wipe. Like, you put your hand on them, and then you pull away really fast.
That's a wipe.
Okay, yeah, I guess it would be a wipe.
I'm gonna hit my children so that my wife has to wipe them.
This is the perfect plan.
So I don't have to do any of the wiping. I did it.
Perfect. I feel like we got it all figured out.
Yeah, I'm parenting 101.
Hit your kids so your spouse has to wipe. God damn it. This is the real See, I knew we'd be asking the real questions here.
I always do.
That's what I know I can count on with you, is we get to the core of it. We get to the core of what really makes the human condition.
Nothing is simple in life, you know? Everything has an extra layer behind it that it's built on. We're always standing on the shoulders of giants.
Right. And I feel like you're the exact person that wants to kill that giant with me.
Well, I mean, you know, standing on the corpses of five giants is probably taller than standing on the shoulders of one.
Yeah, exactly. And it's more structurally sound.
Oh, yeah. You know, at any point that giant can decide, I don't want someone on my shoulders anymore.
Yeah. I mean, you don't like, fall a lot in life physically, but every now and again you do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I figure that you fall more times than you die. So I feel like in the giant's lifetime, it'll fall, and if you're on the shoulder, you're going a lot farther. You're getting launched.
Gonna die in that one.
So this is basic physics. So yeah, you want to kill the giant, and then you want to stack other giants up on top, and then you have like a stronger, like a wider base.
Mm-hmm.
Like
you
a core.
Build a...
Yeah.
build a giant structure, a house out of giant corpses.
Exactly. And then when you're starting to get too tall, then you start killing more giants and like expanding the foundation of the giant pile.
Yeah, this is great.
If you got like a 4x4 base of giants, you could easily stack a corpse pile of giants higher than one single giant.
And that's some property value right there.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's a bit more of like a time commitment and more of an investment. Yeah. But I think when we're talking about something like the future of humanity, that's the route we want to go. We don't just want to like rest on our laurels with the one single giant. We need more.
Find someone else with a corpse pile of giants. Flip it, sell it, make a few bucks. You know?
Oh, so we're
standing on the shoulders of someone else's.
Yeah, we're playing the giant corpse stock market here.
I mean, if giants are a limited resource, this might be such a kind of a short-term idea. But then again, that's how we've always done things.
Yeah, well, I mean, here's the thing. Even if giants are as rare as diamonds, mm-hmm. I feel like even if they're rare, there's enough giants to get taller than one giant.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, hold on a sec. How many corpses do you need to pile up before a person is taller than, like, a regular-sized person? So what's the average height? What, 5'10"? How many corpses do you need to reach 5'10"? 5 feet, 10 inches? Yes.
Well, I mean, let's say, like, average weight, maybe the average person is, like, 3/4 of a foot across. Is that fair to say? A foot's maybe definitely too long. Maybe half a foot, front to back? How, if you stack a corpse, what would that be?
I would say, well, it's America, maybe not. Depends. How fat are they?
I'm just saying on average.
Okay.
Because you're going to have fatter and skinnier, so
okay,
what,
yeah,
like,
so it'll,
half
okay.
a foot? Is that safe?
I would say a foot. I would give it a foot.
You would give it a foot? You would give it a Subway sub?
I'd give it a foot.
I don't know if I'd give it a foot.
All right, you want to give it a foot?
If you hold a Subway sub, which is technically, they're a little less than a foot, if you hold a Subway sub up to your body, do you stick out farther than the Subway sub?
Okay, half a foot.
Yeah, half a foot I think is safe.
Half a foot.
So, if we say half a foot, you only need, like, 11 giants to get to 5.5 feet?
That's a lot of giants.
Let's say 12 giants?
12?
You gotta kill 12 giants.
So the person's alive one.
Yeah.
That's kind of a lot of effort.
Yeah, it's a lot of effort, but you can still do it. You're saying that the issue is resources.
Yeah.
You think there's not 12 giants?
No, I don't think there's 12 giants.
There's, like, There's endangered species that there's more than 12 of them.
Like maybe
once you're getting into, like, white rhino territory, then no. Mm-hmm. But, like, pandas, for example, you can stack a panda corpse pile higher than a panda, no problem.
That is true. You can do that exact thing with pandas pretty easily.
Even if they were, like, skinny pandas.
I've never seen a skinny panda.
You could do it with panda skeletons. You could stack panda skeletons.
Oh, that would look so cool. I kind of want that.
Right, okay. So,
well, now we're a little off track, and I kind of just want panda skeletons in my house.
Yeah, I mean,
That would look really neat.
Yeah, now we're into illegal prize hunting. Which, if you're going to do that, you might as well go the whole the most dangerous game route. And just, you know,
hunt giants.
Yeah. Dinosaurs were good at surviving. They just saw what the future held. Yeah, I guess I do enough praying for the meteor that if I saw one coming, I'd be like, yeah, this is where evolutionarily we should probably cut it off.
Oh, dude, then we would be the monsters in Jurassic Park. Humans.
Yeah. Oh my... Fucking, if dinosaurs were hyper-intelligent, what do you think they'd think about that fucking movie?
Is that what they see us as?
Like, if you were, like, cryogenically frozen, let's say, mm-hmm. or, like, you donate your body to science, and then, like, let's say cat-sized people bring you back. That's about the relative size. Maybe a little bigger.
Or, like, quadrupeds. They'd be like cats. They'd be squirrel cats. Squirrel cat thingies.
Yeah, so, like knee or shin-high squirrel cats bring you back. So you're giant to them. And then you see... you see a fucking movie called Millennial Park. And there's, like, a hipster with a man bun, but probably constructed slightly wrong. He's got scales instead of skin. Mm. And he's just they screaming and eating people.
He'd be eating a bunch of squirrel cats, and they'd be running from him. Yeah, I could dig it. I'm praying for the meteor. That's if the meteor gave us anything, I'd want it to give us that.
You'd want to see that movie. That'd be really weird. That'd be so... yeah, because, like, dinosaurs had feathers.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, I'm sure that we put that skeleton together at least a little bit wrong. Like, we definitely got... So, like, maybe they didn't have tails and they had longer arms. Or, like, there's something we fucked up there for sure. And
I feel like the squirrel cats would make us quadrupeds. They'd have us crawling around on all fours.
You think they would?
Yeah.
I don't know about that. Maybe. Probably. I guess that would make sense.
I think we'd be we'd be like gorillas. They'd make us like gorillas.
That would be a safe bet. That would be a pretty honest mistake, too. And, like, when you think about it, like, the human brain is very good at, like, detecting the uncanny. So even if it's, like, a little bit off, even if they just make the arms slightly longer, you know, and the legs too short, like, we're going to notice that right away. Like, if you CGI a person, even if you're trying to go for anatomically correct and you've got, like, all the pieces, like, you know it.
Yeah.
We can still tell when it's fake. So if you had, like, a piece slightly wrong.
Even, like, the measurements of where the eyes are, if they're, like, a centimeter wrong, you can tell.
Oh, yeah, like, if we had, that would be it, is, like, if the forehead, if, like, our eyes were, like, right up against our hairline or something in that movie, really not that big of a difference, but it would make all the difference.
Well, to us, to them, they'd just be like, ah, scary, woo.
Look at them and their iPods, ah!
I think the scariest bit would be the hands. How, like, they can grab things and pick things up and use things because they, like, have these, you know, thumbs.
Yeah, that would be... I guess hands are kind of a weird, like, nightmarish-looking appendage anyway. Yeah. If you don't... Hands and feet, like toes, would probably be weird as fuck.
Maybe weird, but I would say that the hands would be the most threatening bit. Like, just how the Velociraptor has, like, talons or claws or big teeth or whatever, our hands would be frightening to any other life form.
Yeah, especially if they were small.
Because we could just pick them up.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe instead of eating things, like, the humans would, like, pick them up and, like, start picking body parts off or something.
Oh, God!
That'd be... Yeah, I could see it. I could see Millennial Park.
I hope they wouldn't call it that.
I mean, what would this period of time... Yeah, I mean, they'd have their own language, probably.
It'd probably be something dumb and cat squirrel-like.
Yeah, the clicks and gibbers and... That's the other thing, is, like... I was thinking about aliens the other day.
Yeah?
Okay, thought over. No, I was thinking about aliens the other day.
Yeah?
And, like, if we ever encounter aliens, like, what if they fucking don't communicate or sense in the same way we do? Like, what if they fucking communicate by fucking putting out gas? Like, if their primary form of communication is, like, smell, and they can get across complex thoughts via, like, spores or something.
That sounds plausible.
It does!
Absolutely.
So what if we fucking run into that?
We are fucked. I mean, it depends on how we ran into that. Would we go to their planet? Would they come to ours?
I guess if we went to their planet, it would be fucking weird, because there'd just be, like, all these mushrooms walking around and emitting spores.
I feel like if they came to ours, they would breathe in our gas and our oxygen, and they'd be like, what the hell? Why? Or they'd be like, they're trying to communicate with us.
You think that they've mastered space travel and they wouldn't have mastered... or maybe they just don't have to breathe.
or they get our carbon dioxide, and it's sending them messages, and they're trying to decode that, but all along we're trying to talk to them, and that's not what they're focusing on.
Oh, right, yeah, that would be weird.
Meanwhile, they're emitting sounds that we interpret as language, but really that's their gas, that's them farting and stuff.
Yeah, like imagine if they were... You know those computer sprayer things, or even like spritzer bottles? Like they were like shaped like spritzer bottles, and they just like spritzed each other? That was how they communicated? Mm-hmm. They had like their own telephone, and it was basically like a liquid that could be, you know, various chemicals, kind of like a printer where it like makes the different colors, like it could, you know, print out the different smells into what they interpret as language.
I mean, yeah, I can see it.
I feel like there's a good chance we'd run into that versus something that fucking walked and talked and did all the same things we do. Not exactly that, but you know
but
what I mean.
Yeah, but like, you know,
something equally
as like
weird where we just...
Birds share 99.9% of our DNA and we can't communicate with them. What chance do we have communicating with something not of the Earth?
Yeah. I mean, are birds really that... I don't think birds are that close. I think it's like, it goes like rats, then pigs, then monkeys for level of closeness.
Birds are pretty close.
Are they?
I mean, you know, we all have a common ancestor, but, you know.
That's strange. You think birds would be farther off?
I mean, yeah, I think they're farther off than monkeys, but...
You think given enough time, people can start growing beaks?
Depends on where you put them.
Are there like Indian wonder people that have beaks?
No, why would they need beaks?
I don't know. There's like that one that's fucking growing trees out of his body.
Yeah, but like... Wait, what?
Yeah.
There's what do you
like,
mean?
Okay, there's like all these fucking crazy birth defects in India, and they call them wonders. I guess it's the nice word for like Ripley's believe it or not ass shit. But yeah, there's like a person that's like growing tree parts out of their body.
Uh-huh.
And there's people with like multiple limbs.
Those are deformities. Those are mutations. That's different.
There's people with horns.
Yeah, okay, well, in that case, yes, there can be a person that grows a beak. I wouldn't say, though, that there would be people, like a tribe of people that are all starting to grow a beak, but sure, there could easily be a person that, like, their teeth
But if we wanted to make beak men.
Yeah? Cool. Oh, I'd believe in us.
I guess.
I believe that.
If that was, like, a priority, if it's like, okay, guys... World's ending, we need beaks or we won't live.
If all the food in the world became only available in tiny little seeds planted in trees and we had to use beaks to get them out, we would develop beaks. Absolutely.
Oh god. Fucking hell. Birds are weird.
They're just that way because they needed to be.
Who needed them to be?
They
Certainly
did.
Certainly not me.
They're selfish, just like you.
Stop trying to compare me to them. We're not 99.9% alike.
You're closer than you think. Hating birds is hating yourself.
And I do that too, so I see no problem with this.
So good job, you're already doing it.
I've already admitted to birdosity.
We are closer to pigs than we care to admit.
Oh, yeah. Way closer. I don't see how people can't admit that. Like, they have the same, like, flesh consistency as us. That's weird to me.
Yeah, but... And they're smart, too. Man, and we're so cruel.
Yeah, that's the weirder part, is people are like, oh, we can't eat dogs.
We can't eat dogs.
They're our companions. They're like our little buddies. Meanwhile, fucking pigs are closer to us than dogs and rats, for that matter.
Rats? Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Have you never seen a rat up close?
It's pretty close.
Yeah, they have little human hands. Yeah.
They do.
And they have again. If you shave a rat, it's got like human flesh. Anything with, like, human skin fucking bothers the shit out of me. Like, those,
Have
like...
Have you ever shaved a dog?
Those, like, skinny pigs. Or, like, the Sphinx cats that have no hair. Those fucking bother me. I don't like them.
Oh, yeah, that does bother me. Do you think we'll ever come to a point where we're farming and eating things that are close to people?
I think if anything, we'd go the opposite direction, the way that humanity's heading right now. Yeah.
You think we'll stop eating pigs?
I think that we'd get to a point where we'd be studying like the intelligence of pigs, and then we'd be like, oh no, we can't do this. They actually speak to each other. They emit scents and they fucking speak, or like something weird like that, right?
They've been telling us.
It's like
stuff
the blackfish effect. Remember when blackfish came out and they were like, oh, killer whales are ethical. And then SeaWorld was like, we're gonna stop doing Tillamooks, and then and then they everybody stopped paying attention, and then they were like, okay, back to Tillamooks.
Well, no, they stopped.
They stopped again?
No,
I heard that they stopped, and then people were like, okay, cool, they stopped, and then they were like, okay, never mind, we're starting again.
Well, no, first of all, Tillamook is dead. Second.
We can sleep at night again, knowing that Tillamook is dead.
That thing killed people. I have no remorse for it. That thing is a murderer.
But it feels just
like
you.
Well, no shit,
you.
That's why it killed people. Because it knows. But as far as I'm concerned, it's me versus Tillamooks.
Yeah, exactly. So there should be no more Tillamooks. But yeah, no. I mean, I see. If to answer your question, if we stay on our current trajectory, I see it more as like we'll start adding animals to that list. Like eventually, maybe more and more people will go vegetarian or vegan, or like at least stop eating red meat. Pescatarian.
Okay. I feel like we'll stop using them for shit, but I don't think we'll stop eating them.
I mean, there's already like animal cruelty things, like with like testing and stuff like that. Like we're not even allowed to be as cruel to them as we used to be.
It's a dangerous route to go because being cruel to animals cured polio.
Yeah, did it?
Yeah.
That would make sense. I mean, most of our fucking vaccines and stuff are tested on rats first.
It is a very, very dangerous route to go to, you know, because at a certain point, it really is us versus them.
Right. I feel like people forget that, especially when they're trying to preserve, like, tigers. Like, fuck tigers, dude. You put me in a cage with a tiger, and I'll be wishing the fucking thing was extinct, you know? Like, you put any person, you give any person a gun and put them in a cage with a tiger, and immediately they stop trying to preserve the tiger's life. I don't see why we're trying to save fucking tigers so bad. Fuck them. They are a predator to us. Or they could be. You know, if we were like naked and out in the wild and didn't have firearms. But still, the idea that it could kill you. I mean, we fucking get rid of, we put warning labels on things, and we're like, we have, like, food standards that you can't put something that can possibly kill you, or like, kids can't bring peanuts to school. We'll do that, but we won't let tigers go.
That's the thing. I think we should breed and domesticate them so that they're, you know, less...
We have! People. They're cats! We did that exact thing. We've got cats.
Do we clip their claws and stuff, though? I don't think so.
I think some people clip...
Oh, no, I'm talking about tigers. I guess we did, though, with cats already. Never mind, we don't need tigers, we have cats.
Yeah, exactly. Get rid of them.
That's true.
I feel like if you domesticate a tiger, you just end up with a fucking cat. Because even if you take the claws and the teeth out, then it's like, well, this thing's still big enough to fucking, like, murder me if it wants to. If this thing wants to just smash itself into me, it can still, like, beat me to death. So then you domesticate the size out of it, and you're left with just a fucking cat.
So I say
let him go. I say... Lions and tigers, they can go. They're not doing anything.
Because we have cats and it's redundant.
And see, this is the other thing. Is people are like, oh yeah, if you let those things go, then like the prey animals, they become like an infestation. They become like a pest. And it's like, well then start eating those.
Wait. What's the tiger eat?
Like gazelles and shit.
Shit, we can eat those.
I think there's like a big thing. Is it gazelles or deers or deer's good. Venison is good.
Oh, it's delicious.
Have you ever had it's great.
It's amazing.
But yeah,
hell yeah,
no,
kill the tigers. They're
and fucking, we need to stop using cows anyway. Like, do you know that cow farts puts more shit into the atmosphere than like all of our like cars and stuff combined?
Yes, I've heard that. I don't know if it's true, but I've heard it's a lot of CO2.
I think there's a caveat to it that makes it, like, somehow less bad, but it is true. There is something, though, where it's, like, the type of CO2 is more, like, dissolvent, or I don't know exactly. I haven't studied it, but
regardless, it's CO2. It's
yeah,
a lot of
I
CO2.
I do remember I looked into it at one point, and it was, like, it's true, but this thing. So but it is true. It's still, I'm sure it's still not good, even if it's less or more than cars. It's still not good.
Yeah, no, it's still, still harmful. Okay. I mean, I could, that would be so depressing. I don't know if I'd be able to look at a gazelle farm, because gazelles are pretty known
for,
like,
they're trying to start making kangaroo meat a thing, because they have too many of those. They've become, an infestation.
It is a thing. They have kangaroo jerky and stuff.
Well, they were starting to try to get it to catch on in Australia, and then they started exporting it here, and then it became illegal here. The FDA made it so you can't sell kangaroo meat anymore.
Why?
I think probably because it interfered with some market and fucking corporations own everything.
They find out they can eat kangaroos, they'll stop eating cow.
Exactly! No, that's just how the fucking world works. That's not even conspiracy theory, there's no gold behind our money shit. That's, like, real. Well, there is no gold behind our money, that's real too. Maybe that was a bad example. But you shouldn't, you might or not, I don't know, you may, buy gold, sure, buy gold, whatever. But
it's safe, right?
No, that's not even, like, a conspiracy thing. It's like, for example, do you know 23andMe? Have you ever heard of that?
No, what's that?
23andMe is a thing where you order it and you spit in a vial and you send it back, and they run your spit through a bunch of, like, DNA testing, and they do a bunch of tests, and it tells you, like, your full genealogy, like where your ancestors are from, and it can also tell you if you have certain strains and DNA types that are more prone to, like, certain diseases and things like that.
Oh yeah, okay.
And in America, 23andMe cannot show you certain results.
Oh my god!
Because it interferes with the medical industry. So if you do 23andMe in Canada, which is why when I do it, I'm gonna go to Canada and I'm gonna use a Canadian, like, address. But if you use it in Canada, it'll tell you a bunch more shit. But in the U.S., there's, like, a ton of stuff that they're like, yeah, we have results for this, but we can't tell you because it's illegal.
Oh, that's shady as fuck.
Yeah, because it's, and again, I'm sure that, like, the bullshit answer would be like, are you really gonna test a machine? But the machine is, like, it's super accurate. It's like the same kind of test a fucking doctor would run. It's just you don't have to see a doctor and pay them money.
How much is it?
It's like $250, I want to say.
Shit. That's really scary.
So it's about the cost of an uninsured doctor visit. Mm-hmm. Assuming you don't need any special tests done at the doctor's, which to get this kind of result you would.
Wow. All right. Well.
But
can
yeah.
You just do this in Canada. You can go there and be like, "This is me. I spit. Do it."
I suppose. I don't see what would be stopping you from, like, doing it in Canada and then, like, looking at it from, like I don't know what kind of protocols they have in place to make sure. Like, I'm sure they don't ask you for, like, your social security number or something.
Hmm.
Or, like, proof of citizenship. But yeah, no, it's just dumb shit like that. Like, we have a lot of things like that where it's like, this interferes with this money-making industry, so it's just illegal now.
No, hold on, someone made a good point. Like, how do you know they're really telling you this? You can just see spitting into a thing and they'll just tell you whatever they want.
They could be lying to you, that's true.
Which is genius. Spit into this cup and I'll tell you what's wrong with you.
Well, I feel like you'd know, right? Because
would you?
Yeah, because it tells you things about, like, your heritage, and it'll give you a bunch of, like, useless information too that they can just surmise. Like, oh yeah, the people with this gene are more likely to be short. People with this gene are more likely to have dark hair. And, like, my girlfriend did it, and it does a lot of things, like, describe her, like, body type and things like you. You'll be able to tell. Like, okay. It's pretty, and it's not like you send it in with a picture of yourself. So it's not like they're able to figure it out.
this is me, this is my spit.
And it's, again, they tell you, like, what part of the world your ancestors are from. They don't have that information.
Well, like who knows, they could be looking at your Facebook and watching your streams.
I suppose that's true, but that only would make sense if you were a fucking, like, oh, I'm from here, this is my heritage, I regularly post about my heritage. Thanks, Facebook, for telling everyone.
Well, they could also be taking that spit and using it later for their own nefarious...
Yeah, that's also something you gotta be careful with.
I mean, talk about living forever, you know, your clone might live...
Exactly, but I'm fine. Any kind of genetic tampering, as long as, like, if the building blocks of, like, an army of the future comes from my DNA, I'd be happy with that.
Why?
Because it's like you took it over yourself.
They would make all the same mistakes you were prone to make.
Exactly.
Do you think you...
That'd be hilarious.
If the world was run by an army of people, like, with your compulsions, what would be the first thing to be fucked up?
Well, the first thing I would ruin,
mm-hmm.
if I was just in charge of the world.
Not even intentionally, just, like, would you accidentally, like...
I feel like a lot of humanitarian things would probably go to shit. I feel like that would probably be the first thing. Is I'd be like, look, there's a lot of stuff in Haiti. Why do we need to save it? They don't have food. Let's just let them not have food for a while and then come in. We'll get all the resources. I feel like I have too much of, like, a Alexander the Great complex to run things.
I feel like I would be the opposite, where I would just oversimplify the problems and then try to fix them that way, and then I'd get the... Like, I would be like, oh, they don't have food, and we have a lot of food, so let's take all our food and give it to them. And then, like, in transport, all the food goes bad, and now neither person has food. And right. Be like, oh, darn, this is more complicated than I thought it would be.
And then you'd just be like, I was trying to help, and then...
Oh, well, you know what? I tried, and that's what counts. And yeah. Then my entire army would be like, you tried, and that's what counts.
They'd fucking move... Before they drag your corpse through the streets, you'd be like, I tried, and then they'd be like, okay. Like fucking Mussolini.
Well, we're here to make sure you don't try again. That's fair. I get it.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
Yeah.
Oh, shucks.
Shucks. I guess I deserve to be executed. Oh, well.
Is there a measurement for, like, butthole elasticity? What? Is there, like, a word for that? Like, I learned the term Norwoods the other day. You know what Norwoods are?
No, what's that?
Apparently there's something called the Norwood scale, and it's a scale of how bald you are.
Go on.
So I wonder if there's something like that for, like, rectal elasticity. Like, if there's, like, a famous porn star who took, like, 3 dicks at a time in the ass, and that's, like, who it's named after.
2.5 phase. 2.5. Fucking... you would start including that in your measurements.
Yeah.
When, like, in your porn resume.
But, I mean, there's gotta be that for, like, butt plugs, right? Like, there's different size. When you're, like, working your way up...
That's true, because you can't try butt plugs on before using them.
Right, so there's gotta be, like, some kind of measurement. Now, they might just go by, like, width. That'd be the boring way to go. But I feel like something like that... I don't know. Maybe if it becomes more popular. But I feel like there's enough of the gay out there, too, mm-hmm. where they have to use that hole to where it's gotta be a thing.
Okay, how would you measure it? Just by, like, how much your butthole can stretch, minus how much it is when it's closed?
Yeah, I suppose. Or, I mean, I guess,
That sounds like inches. That sounds like you can measure that with length or girth or
inches.
Circumference. Yes.
I don't know if inches is the right... I think you gotta go metric if you're measuring butthole elasticity.
Maybe.
Foreigners are wrong about a lot of things, but when it comes to taking it in the butt, they are unmatched.
They're a proud people.
Well, we just fucking rolled right through that.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot there was a video game going on, kind of.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So after a while, it just sort of becomes like breathing.
Yeah.
You know, it's funny, like, when I went to your house and we played Smash, like, I felt like it was just like, this is the new way to have a conversation. I wasn't even... It was like a normal conversation, more
than
just looking at each other was a normal conversation.
They're fucking video-based social crushes where you can avoid making eye contact, and it's
like,
not weird.
Because when you're just sitting there and talking one-on-one, it's a lot more intimate, but yeah, it's a lot more awkward, too.
Yeah, I suppose. There's... Yeah, there is something about it that it's like, yeah, people can never be bored nowadays. You notice that?
I have not been bored in a long time.
When was the last time you were genuinely bored?
Well, it was because I have a phone. That's part of it, anyway.
Exactly. Everyone's always got something to, like, take out of their pocket and fiddle with.
Mm-hmm. It's really sad, because I feel like a lot of innovation has come from being bored.
Yeah, exactly. Like phones.
Yes! I mean, they didn't have something, and they made something. If we keep having things, we won't make anything else.
You know what I guess Overwatch would maybe fall into this camp. But what I don't like is things that are meant to be like repetitive. Like a lot of mobile games have this, where it's like they just put you on a fucking like grind. Like even when I like fall for them sometimes, it's like, ugh, man, I'm in a fucking Skinner box. Like when we talk about being bored, right? Like, how much of your time has Overwatch, for example, taken up?
Probably like 40 hours total.
Right, and how much of that is like unique experience?
A good amount of it.
Maybe on a certain level.
But 100% came from the social aspect of it.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
It 100% came off with, when I had the experience with that guy. It was never because of the game itself. It was always because of someone else, like, doing something.
And that's fine if it's built around that, right? But, like, mobile games, where they're, like, single player.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't have that aspect to it. I don't know. There's something about that that is probably detrimental to humanity if we're looking at it in, like, the nuts and bolts, right? Because it's, like... I'm not saying that necessarily being bored is good, right? But you play 100 Overwatch matches, and you've pretty much seen most of what you're gonna see in the entirety of playing it, right?
Well, that's why they have updates. That's why they add new characters.
Yeah, I suppose.
That's really.
But I'm saying like it's like the difference of I'm gonna watch 10 movies and see all those different perspectives and different things and, like, things made different ways versus I'm just gonna watch one movie 10 times. You know, I feel like...
Or the same kind of movie 10 times.
Yeah. I'm poorly articulating this, but do you see
What is your point exactly?
Are you actually not getting it, or are you...
I'm getting it, but like, what is your main thesis here?
Oh no, I'm just saying that things like that, like entertainment and art and things like that that, you know, distract you or make it so you're not bored, I don't think is inherently bad or inherently counterintuitive, unless it's just something that's designed to keep you engaged in like repetition versus like encountering unique ideas and experiences.
Yeah, I agree.
Because
with that.
It's really like, and the human mind is made to be trapped in little like ruts like that, I'm sure, which is why they're so effective. But I think that there is something to like the detriment of humanity if you take that into account. Oh boy, my clicker treat! I got a loot box! Hooray!
Yeah, that's, you pretty much made your point. You could have just said that, actually.
Right?
Oh boy, now I get to see if I have the chance to get an item that will make my character look slightly different while I do the same
action. I can maybe get something I want, and the idea of not getting the thing I want makes me want it more. That's healthy. Oh, man. Mm. I feel like I need to go outside, so I think that's a stream.
I mean, yeah.
Thanks for stopping by, everybody. Thanks, Ship, for showing up. If you haven't checked out Ship's stuff, shippage on pretty much everything. Want to say your shippage on everything?
Yep.
Was that a plug?
Yeah, that's a real thing.
No, really?
No. Stupid.
Damn it. You got me again. You fucking bamboozled me.
You've been had yet again.
God damn it. All right, fuck everything. I'm gonna go die now. Bye!